हेलो एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल फिजिक्स कैफे बाय मनजीत कौर। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट वाइब्रेशंस, वेव्स एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस डैम्प सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन एंड टाइप्स ऑफ डैम्पिंग विच इज़ अंडर यूनिट फर्स्ट। So today's our topic is damped mechanical oscillator and types of damping. Before we study about damped mechanical oscillator, first we know what is damped oscillations. So when a body is set into vibrations, it oscillates with its natural frequency. The frequency of oscillation produced depend on the geometry, and at time the amplitude of its oscillations goes on decreasing. So dear student, damped ऑसिलेशन में जब एक सिस्टम को जब एक बॉडी को सेट कर देते हैं ऑसिलेशंस में, वो ऑसिलेट करती है विद नेचुरल फ्रिक्वेंसी एंड दैट टाइम उसका जो एम्पलीट्यूड है वो डिक्रीज होता जाता है, तो उन ऑसिलेशंस को वी कॉल डैम्प्ड ऑसिलेशंस। हियर दिस इज वाई एक्सिस एंड दिस इज एक्स एक्सिस। So in this diagram you can easily see that the amplitude of the oscillations gradually decreases with time. Here along x axis we take time and along y axis we take amplitude, right? So here we have the definition of damped oscillator, an oscillator which produces oscillations of decreasing amplitude due to dissipation of energy during each oscillations is called damped oscillator. वो oscillator जो produce करता है oscillations, इसमें क्या हो रहा है उसका जो amplitude है वो क्या हो रहा है, decrease हो रहा है due to dissipation of energy और each oscillations में, तो उसको क्या कहते हैं, is called damped oscillator. So let's start its derivation. Here we have a diagram in which mass m is attached to a spring of mass m, and this is point p and this is c, and distance between p and c is denoted by x, and here f which is restoring force act opposite to x directions x axis, and here resistive force is also act opposite to x axis, and this is O. So this is the diagram. So here consider a damped mechanical simple harmonic oscillator in which mass m is attached to a spring of stiffness s is produced the oscillations. तो आपने क्या करना है, एक डैम्प मैकेनिकल सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर में एक आपने मास एम को अटैच किया है विद स्प्रिंग के साथ, और उसमें वेरियस फोर्सेस उस टाइम पे प्रोड्यूस होते हैं। सो हियर अ डिसिपेटिव फोर्स दैट वेरियस डायरेक्टली एज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द ऑसिलेटर। देन डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी नो वी विच इज इक्वल्स टू डी एक्स अपॉन डी टी। सो हियर वी डिस्कस कि फोर्स है जो आपका वो डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल है वेलोसिटी के। So here we take F is directly proportional to dx upon dt, and next force is F which is resistive force which is equals to minus R dx upon dt. So here that show ki resistive force is directly proportional to the velocity and R is the constant of proportionality. So here this is our equation number 1. So next, if m is the mass of the particle executing simple harmonic motion, then according to Newton's second law of motion, we have equation that is force which is equals to m d square x upon dt square. Dear students, in previous classes you know F which is equals to mass into acceleration. So acceleration is equals to d square x upon dt square. So simply here I put the value of acceleration which is d square x upon dt square, which is our equation number 2. So if x is the displacement, then restoring force is given by अगर एक्स की आई डिस्प्लेसमेंट है तो उसमें रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स क्या होएगा, दैट इज एफ विच इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू एक्स. हियर प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी कॉन्स्टेंट इज माइनस एस. हियर प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी कॉन्स्टेंट इज एस. सो वी कैन राइट एफ विच इज इक्वल्स टू माइनस एस इन टू एक्स. सो हियर एस इज द स्टिफनेस कॉन्स्टेंट. द स्प्रिंग प्रोवाइड द रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स दैट इज माइनस एस एक्स टू द टेस्ट मास. सो इन मैकेनिकल ऑस्किलेटर अ पार्ट ऑफ इट्स एनर्जी इज ऑलवेज डिसिपेटेड अगेन द डिसिपेटिव फोर्सेज सच एज फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स, विस्कस ड्रैग ड्यू टू एयर एक्सेट्रा. फॉर द सेक ऑफ कन्वीनियंस वी टेक इन टू अकाउंट द विस्कस ड्रैग ड्यू टू एयर ओनली. सो डिसिपेटिव फोर्सेज दैट वी गेट आर डायरेक्टली proportional to the velocity, same as directly proportional to the displacement of the object, displacement of the spring. So here, which is our equation number third, in which F is equals to minus S into X. So from equation first, second and third, because in that oscillations then various forces acting on the system. So first force we have restoring force, another is resistive force, and the first one is that is the equation of motion by using Newton's law. So we can combine all these equation, so we get the equation of motion for a damped mechanical oscillator may be written as md square x upon dt square, which is equals to minus r dx, which is equals to minus sx. Dear students, we know this is equals to F, which is equation of motion, and these both forces which act on the spring. So this is also equals to F and this is also equals to F. So we can equate this equation. So we get equation number 4. Now we rearrange this equation, md square x upon dt square plus rd x upon dt plus sx, which is equals to 0, which is our equation number 5. So in X, the equation 5 is called the differential equation of the damped simple harmonic mechanical oscillator. So equation 5 है जो आपकी वो आपकी differential equation है किसकी, damped simple harmonic oscillator की, this one. So in order to solve the equation 5, let us substitute. We can take R upon M which is equals to 2B and same S upon M which is equals to omega square. So we put the value of R upon M and S upon M in equation 5. So we get d square x upon dt square plus 2b plus omega square x, which is equals to 0. Next, now we have to find the solution of that differential equation. So we put x which is equals to Ae alpha t. Now we differentiate both sides of our equation with respect to t. So we get dx upon dt which is equals to a alpha e alpha t. Now again we differentiate this equation, that is equation number 7. So we get d square x upon dt square which is equals to a alpha square e alpha t, which is our equation number 8. Now we put all these equations in equation number 5, so we get a alpha square e alpha t plus 2b into a alpha e alpha t plus omega square a alpha a exponential alpha t, which is equals to 0. Now we see what is common in this equation. So here very easily we see e raised to alpha t, which is common in all these terms. So we take common, a is also common, so we can take common a exponential alpha t. So inside the bracket we get alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square, which is equals to 0. So this equation is equals to 0, so this term will be equals to 0. When it goes here, so it will come 0. So we get alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square, which is equals to 0. Now we can easily see this equation is a quadratic equation in terms of alpha. So we get the roots. So in next step we get its roots alpha, which is equals to minus 2b plus minus 4b square minus 4 omega square upon 2. Next, alpha which is equals to minus 2b plus minus here 4, here 4 is also present. So we take out 4 from this square root. So here we can write 2. Now here 2 and here 2. So we can write this step as 2, 1 plus minus v square minus omega square upon 2. So here 2 is cancelized. So we get alpha which is equals to minus v plus minus under root v square minus omega square. So from the equation 4, put the value of v and omega square. So we get minus r upon 2m plus minus under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m. Then alpha 1 and alpha 2 are the roots of the equation. Then we get the value of alpha 1 and similarly for alpha 2. For because here we get equation in plus minus. So for in first term that is alpha 1 we take plus and for alpha 2 here we take minus. So we can write alpha 1 which is equals to minus r upon 2m plus under root square r square upon 4m square minus s upon m. Same for alpha 2 we can write minus r upon 2m minus under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m. So now the solution of the equation 5th in its complete form is given by x which is equals to a1 exponential alpha 1t plus a2 exponential alpha 2t. I hope ki aapko pata hoga ki j equation kaise aayi hai because we take the solution of equation 5th which is the differential equation of simple damped mechanical oscillator which is a exponential alpha t. But when we solve the equation we get the quadratic equation. So then we find the alpha 1 and alpha 2. So that's why we take this equation like this. So we can write x which is equals to a1 exponential alpha 1t plus a2 exponential alpha 2t. So now we put the value of another that is alpha 1 and alpha 2. So we get x which is equals to a1 exponential minus r upon 2m plus r under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m into t plus a2 exponential minus r upon m minus square root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m into t. So in this equation we just put the value of alpha 1 this is and alpha 2 this is. So the above equation gives a general solution of the differential equation of damped simple harmonic mechanical oscillator which describes the oscillations produced by the damped oscillations. The nature of the oscillations is described by the above exponent part of this equation. So ये इक्वेशन हमें क्या बता रही है जो डैम्प ऑस्किलेटर ने इसमें से ऑस्किलेशंस को डिस्क्राइब किया है एंड इसकी नेचर अगर आपने ऑस्किलेशंस की नेचर को फाइंड करना है वो हमें इसका एक्सपोनेंट पार्ट बताएगा इस इक्वेशन का दैट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ ई. सो नेक्स्ट वी हैव टाइप्स ऑफ डैम्पिंग. सो हियर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द रिलेटिव वैल्यूज ऑफ द फैक्टर दैट इज r square upon 4m square and s upon m, the damping is of following three types. So in first case we will take when r square upon 4m square is greater than from s upon m. Next for our convenience we can write r upon 2m which is equals to p and under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m which is equals to q. So dear student, here we take case that is r square upon 4m square which is greater than from s upon m. It implies that the damping resistance term that is r square upon 4m square dominates the stiffness term that is s upon m because r square upon 4m square is greater than from s upon m. So to investigate the nature of damping, so we denote p r upon 2m as p as this term as q. So next we put the values of r upon 2m and q square root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m, which is q. So we get x which is equals to a1 exponential minus p plus q into t plus a2 exponential minus p minus q into t. So here when we multiply this term t with this brackets, then we get, here I solve you this step, x a1 exponential minus pt plus qt plus a2 exponential minus pt minus qt. So here we can easily see exponential minus pt is common in both terms. So here we take out exponential minus pt, bracket a1 exponential qt plus a2 exponential minus qt, which is our equation number y. So dear students, we know e raised to power x, which is equals to cos h x plus sin h x. So we use that identity, and same for exponential minus x. E raised to power exponential minus x, which is equals to cos x minus sin x. So we are using that identities, we get exponential qt, which is equals to cos h qt plus sin h qt, and say for exponential minus qt, which is equals to cos h qt minus sin h qt. So we put these values in equation number y. So we get x, which is equals to exponential minus pt, then bracket a1 cos h qt plus sin h qt, bracket close, plus a2 bracket cos h qt minus sin h qt. Now here when we multiply a1 with this bracket and same for a2 with this bracket, then we get, then we take common cos h qt, because here when we solve this term, we get exponential minus pt a1 cos h qt plus a1 sin h qt plus a2 cos h qt minus a2 sin h qt. So dear students, here we see cos h qt and cos h qt is common. So we take common in next step, x which is equals to exponential minus pt bracket a1 plus a2 into cos h qt, and same for sin h, so we take common plus sin h qt a1 minus a2, because here negative sign is of a2, so here we take minus. In next, for our convenience, we can write a1 a2 denote with c, and same for a1 minus a2 denoted with d. So we can write x which is equals to exponential minus pt c cos h qt plus d sin h qt. So now in next step, we put the values of p and q in this above equation, in this equation. So we get x which is equals to exponential minus r upon 2m t bracket cos h bracket under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m into t plus d sin h bracket under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m into t, which is our equation number z. So dear students, here we just put the values of q and p. So from equation z, it follows that when r square upon 4m square is greater than from s upon m, the displacement x no longer remains periodic, that is sine or in cosine function of time. So it is because cos h and sin h functions are non-periodic functions. Therefore, the variations of displacement x with time is non-oscillatory in nature. So the presence of factor, that is exponential minus r upon 2m into t in the expression for x, makes the displacement to decay 0 exponentially. So at t equals to 0, first we draw its diagram. So this is a xy plane. So here the oscillations is decreasing with respect to time. Time is along x axis and displacement is along, taken along y axis. So at t equals to 0, t equals to 0, the displacement is maximum, and when it increases, then the displacement is decayed to 0 exponentially, will vary with time. So this is the case when the oscillator is called heavily damped or over damped oscillator. When we take the case when r square upon 4m square is greater than from s upon m. So in next case, when we take r square upon 4m square, which is equal to s upon m, so in equation y we put the value of q equals to 0. So first I explain you how we get the q, which is equals to 0. Dear student, as we know, we denote p and q, p with r upon 2m and q with r square upon square upon 4m square minus s upon m, which is equals to q square. So q, which is equals to under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m. So when we take the case this one, when r square upon 4m square, which is equals to sm, so this equation will become r square upon 4m square. Here in place of sm, we can write r square upon 4m square, which is equals to q. So here this is plus and this is minus, so 0, which is equals to, so q, which is equals to 0. So by using this one, here we put the value of q equals to 0 in equation y. So we get x, which is equals to exponential minus pt, a1 exponential 0 plus a2 exponential minus 0. Then which is equals to, first we solve this one equation, x which is equals to exponential minus pt. Dear student, e raised to power 0, which is equals to 1. So here we can write a1 plus a2. So we get this equation, x which is equals to a1 plus a2 into exponential minus pt. So here we note a1 plus a2 with a c, which is a constant. So which is equals to c exponential minus pt. Here we put the value of p in this equation. So we get x which is equals to c e exponential c into exponential minus r upon 2m into t. So dear student, as we taken this equation, dear student, as we taken differential equation in which we use second degree equation, so in this equation, that is our this one equation, here we see just only one constant comes, so which is not a valid solution of our equation. So this in fact the limiting case of heavily damped motion, and it cannot be accepted as a valid solution of the differential equation of a simple harmonic oscillator. So it is because since the differential equation is a second degree differential equation, its solution must contain two constants. So to find the valid solution instead of minus r upon 4m square being equal to s upon m, we consider the case in which r square upon 4m square is slightly greater than from s upon m. सो डियर स्टूडेंट, इस केस में जो आपने अभी इसको सोल्व किया है, इसमें हमने देखा बिकॉज आपका जो कॉन्स्टेंट है वो एक सिंगल कॉन्स्टेंट सी आया है, बट जो आपकी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन थी सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर में वो सेकेंड डिग्री डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन थी, तो उसकी वजह से इसमें जो हमारे पास कॉन्स्टेंट आने चाहिए वो भी आपके टू आने चाहिए, बट इसमें तो एक आया है. सो दिस इज नॉट द वैलिड सोल्यूशन. So for this valid solution, to find the valid solution of this equation, so we take जहाँ पे हमने इसको इसके इक्वल लिया ना कि r square upon 4m square which is equals to s upon m, उसको लेने के बजाय हम ले लेंगे कि r upon 4m square s upon m से थोड़ा सा स्लाइटली सा ग्रेटर है. सो लेते हैं वो केस व्हेन q which is equals to under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m which is equals to delta, that means r square upon 4m square is slightly greater than from s upon m. So because of small difference, the equation y may be written as x which is equals to exponential minus pt bracket a1 exponential delta t plus a2 exponential minus delta t. Here we just put the value of q in this equation. So expanding an exponential series, we get x which is equals to exponential minus pt a1 1 plus delta t plus delta t square upon 2 victorial plus 3 delta t cube upon 3 victorial plus and so on plus a2 bracket 1 minus delta t plus delta t square upon 2 victorial plus delta t whole cube upon 3 victorial plus and so on. Here we just use the mathematical terms, that is e raised to power x ko and e raised to power minus x. उनको उसको जस्ट हमने एक्सपेंड किया है. e raised to power x which is equals to 1 plus x plus x square upon 2 victorial plus x cube upon 3 victorial and so on. Same for e raised to power minus x. 1 minus x plus x square upon 2 victorial minus x cube upon 3 victorial and so on. Here we just use these two identities. So next, since delta is very small, so we neglect the higher powers. कौन सी higher powers? यहाँ पे हमें मिल रही है this one and this one. So we get x which is equals to exponential minus pt bracket a1 plus a2 plus a1 minus a2 into t. So here a1 plus a2 को again we denote करेंगे a dash के साथ and a1 minus a2 we denoted with b dash. So we get the equation x which equals to a minus pt a dash plus b dash t. And here we put the value of p in this equation. So we get x which is equals to a dash plus b dash t exponential minus rt upon 2m. So it may be pointed out that while the constant a dash has the dimensions of length and same for b dash has the dimensions of velocity. So from this equation, it follows that the behavior of the system is again non-oscillatory in nature. It is because x is not expressed as a sine of a function, sine or a cosine function of time t. Same, the presence of factor e, that is minus r upon 2m into t in the expression for x, makes the displacement to decays to 0. So here I draw its diagram. Here we take xy plane so this is origin and this is time taken along x axis and same displacement is taken along y axis. Here comes y. So dear students, the presence of factor e raised to power minus rt upon 2m in the expression for x makes the displacement decays to 0. So in much larger time due to the presence of factor a dash plus b dash t. So at t equals to 0, the displacement is again maximum, which is in case of heavily damped or over damped oscillator in also. So here displacement is also maximum as the displacement then the displacement will vary with time, it decreases and here it becomes 0. So such an oscillator is called critically damped oscillator and the system is said to be dead weight system. So this is case, this is the diagram when we take the case, that is r square upon 4m square minus s upon m which is equals to delta and this is equals to q. So this graph we get when we take r square upon 4m square is slightly greater than from s upon m. Now we have the last type of damping, when in case r square upon 4m square is less than from s upon m. So it implies that the stiffness term, that is s upon m, dominates the damping resistance, that is r square upon 4m square. So such an oscillator is called light damped or a undamped oscillator. So when r square upon 4m square is less than from s upon m, the factor r square upon 4m square minus s upon m is negative. So we take r square upon 4m square minus s upon m is a imaginary term. So investigate this type of damping. Let us note r square under root r square upon 4m square minus s upon m, which is equals to minus bracket s upon m minus r square upon 4m square, because here s upon m is greater than from r square upon 4m square. So that's why here we take s upon m minus r square upon 4m square, and minus sign is taken out from this bracket. Because of this sign, negative sign, which is present in this under inside the square root, so that's why we take its I, that is imaginary part. So here, which is iota, so square root s upon m minus r square upon 4m square. So this equation, which is equals to r square upon 4m square minus s upon m, this one, which is equals to I omega dash. Here we denote this one with a omega dash. So we put the value of r upon 2m, which is equals to p, and same omega dash in the equation 10. So it becomes x, which is equals to a1 exponential minus b plus I omega dash into t plus a2 exponential minus b minus I omega dash into t. So here again we solve this term, so we get x, which is equals to exponential minus bt, which is common here and which is common in this term also. So exponential minus bt bracket a1 exponential iota omega dash t plus a2 exponential minus iota omega dash t. So here again I use identity for iota, exponential iota x and exponential minus iota x. So which is equals to cos, which is equals to cos x plus iota sin x, and same for this one, cos x minus iota sin x. So we use both these identities here in this equation. So we get x, which is equals to exponential minus pt bracket a1 cos omega dash t plus I sin omega dash t bracket close plus a2 bracket cos omega dash t minus iota sin omega dash t. Then exponential, here when we solve this term we get, here I solve this equation, x minus pt a1 cos omega dash t plus iota plus a1 iota sin omega dash t bracket close plus bracket start plus a2 cos omega dash t minus a2 iota sin omega dash t bracket close. So here cos omega dash t and cos omega dash t is common. So here we take this equation x, which is equals to exponential minus pt a1 plus a2 cos omega dash t plus same for sin omega dash, so we taken out from this bracket. Here we write plus iota a1 minus a2 sin omega dash t. So dear students, here we denote a1 plus a2, which is equals to a naught cos phi, and same for minus a1 minus a2, which is equals to a naught sin phi. So our equation will become x, which is equals to exponential minus pt bracket a naught cos omega dash t into cos phi plus a naught sin omega dash t plus sin phi. So this is again, so here we again use identity, which is cos a minus b, which is equals to cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. So by using this identity we get this equation x, which is equals to a naught exponential minus pt cos omega t omega dash t minus phi. Here omega dash t is a and phi is b. So next, putting the value of p and omega dash, so we get x, which is equals to a naught exponential minus rt upon 2m into cos bracket s under root s cone m minus r square cone 4 m square into t minus phi. So it follows that the oscillatory oscillatory motion of the amplitude, that is a node exponential minus r cone 2 m into t, and the angular frequency, that is under root s cone m minus r square upon 4 m square, and have a phase difference, that is phi, with the undamped simple harmonic motion, and a node and phi node are the two values which we, you can, if you want, you can solve this equation further. So this is the graph for three types of damping. So first we have a underdamping, which is the last case. So this graph shows the motion is oscillatory but neither simple harmonic periodic, as the amplitude of the oscillations, that is a node exponential minus rt upon 2m, is not a constant. So it decreases with time. Even if the damping is very small, then the motion is nearly periodic. Here this motion is nearly periodic because that amplitude is decreases very slowly, and it may taken as constant over large number of cycles, time period of oscillations. And next we have a next graph, that is for critical damping. So critical damping, the figure shows the critical damping, the system does not oscillate at all, and the system once disturbed from equilibrium position returns to equilibrium in shortest period possible time. That is, critical damping is a practical importance. So next case, that is a first one we taken, that is over damping or heavy damping. So in this case, which is which is also equals critical damping. So in this, the displacement versus time graph of a heavily damped system is shown in figure. So here the cos h and sin h are non-periodic functions. So this behavior of heavily damped system is also not periodic, that is not oscillator at all. So in this case, the system disturbed from its equilibrium position returns to equilibrium position very slowly but does not cross the equilibrium position. So in critical damping, the system returns to equilibrium position in a minimum position time, whereas in heavy damping system, system takes too long time to return to its equilibrium position. So the behavior is non-oscillatory in both these cases, for this one and for this one. So in fact, critical damping is a special case of a heavy damping. So these are the three types of damping here we discuss. So I hope, dear students, you clear all topic with very detail. In this lecture we study about damped mechanical oscillator and the types of damping. So I hope you like this lecture. So if you like, then you can subscribe my channel, you can share my channel with your friends, and thank you for watching.